What's up, everybody? Welcome to a new English Beat. I'm Katia. Today, I've got a new quiz for you, this time focused on collocations. Are you ready for this tricky challenge? If so, grab a pen and a piece of paper, and let's kick off. First, what is a collocation? It's a combination of words that are often used together. For example, heavy rain and not strong rain. Another example, a hard frost. Or to make a discovery and not to do a discovery. So in today's quiz, there will be 10 questions with 2 and even 3 options. You're going to choose A, B, or C. Write down your answer, very important. And in the second part of the lesson, I'm going to give you the correct answers and you're going to get your score. Ready? Break a leg. So the first sentence, I was born in the Ukraine, but Spain is my A, adopted country, or B, adoptive country. I was born in the Ukraine, but Spain is my A, adopted country, or B, adoptive country. Choose the correct answer, A or B. Very important, write it down, and let's continue. Number 2, Crime and Punishment by Dostoevsky is A, a timeless classic, or B, an untimely classic. Crime and Punishment by Dostoevsky is A, a timeless classic, or option B, is an untimely classic. Pick A or B and write it down. Let's move on to our sentence number 3. A lot of people have suffered great A, hardship, B, hardness in 2020. A lot of people have suffered great A, hardship, B, hardness in 2020. Choose the correct option and write it down. Number 4, there has been an option A, appreciative increase in unemployment, or option B, there has been an appreciable increase in unemployment. Choose the correct adjective in this sentence. Let's continue. Number 5, look out for this guy. Appearances can be A, deceptive, or B, deceitful. Look out for this guy. Appearances can be A, deceptive, or B, deceitful. Number 6, Isaac Newton, A, did an important contribution to science, or option B, Isaac Newton made an important contribution to science. Choose A or B and write it down. Number 7, he didn't have any A, supportive evidence to prove he wasn't guilty, or option B, he didn't have any supporting evidence to prove he wasn't guilty. The same, choose the correct answer, A or B. Number 8, she felt option A, a surge of anger when he stood her up, or she felt a rush of anger when he stood her up. The same, make your choice, A or B. Our second to last sentence, I'm hopeless, I tried every, and here we've got 3 options. A, imaginable, B, imaginary, or C, imaginative. Solution, but nothing worked out. I'm hopeless, I tried every, A, imaginable, B, imaginary, or C, imaginative. Solution, but nothing worked out. Choose A, B, or C. And last but not least, number 10, the Spanish government has A. approved, B. passed a new law making COVID tests compulsory for tourists. The Spanish government has A. approved, B. passed a new law making COVID tests compulsory for tourists. So the same, the last one, choose A, approved, or B, passed. And guys, before we continue and find out your score, just a super quick reminder, please make sure you're subscribed to English Bits and your notifications are turned on. There is a weekly lesson waiting for you. And now let's find out your score. Number one, the correct option is A. I was born in the Ukraine, but Spain is my adopted country. So the adjective adoptive is mainly used with parents. For example, he adores his adoptive parents. And in most occasions, we would use adopted. For example, an adopted brother or an adopted kitten. So if you've got an A in this sentence, you can put a tick and you've got 1 point. Number two, the correct answer is also an A. Crime and Punishment by Dostoevsky is a timeless classic. Timeless is something that lasts forever and doesn't change as time goes by. And untimely is used to refer to something bad that happens too soon, like a death or an end. An example sentence, the series had an untimely end. Let's continue. Number three, the correct answer is A. A lot of people have suffered great hardship in 2020. So hardship is something difficult and unpleasant, while hardness is a neutral word and it's something difficult to bend, cut, or break. An example sentence, the material is very resistant to the weather. It's characterized by its hardness. Number four, the correct option is B. There has been an appreciable increase in unemployment this year. So appreciable means large enough to be considered important, while appreciative means grateful. For example, she's an appreciative guest. Number five, the correct option is A. Look out for this guy. Appearances can be deceptive. So something deceptive makes you believe that something is not true. And it's usually used with abstract concepts or things. While the adjective deceitful is used to describe people who are dishonest, hide the truth, and want to deceive others. An example sentence, they were hoodwinked by this deceitful person. Number six, the correct answer is B. Isaac Newton made an important contribution to science. Remember that it's to make a contribution and not to do. Number seven, the correct answer is B. He didn't have any supporting evidence to prove he wasn't guilty. So a supporting evidence proves something. We also use the adjective supporting with an actor, part, or role. An example sentence, Justin Hartley is a supporting actor. While the adjective supportive means someone who gives you help and encouragement. For example, she's been such a supportive friend. Number eight, the correct answer is A. She felt a surge of anger when he stood her up. So we can also say a surge of happiness, excitement, or loneliness, and a rush for example, a rush of adrenaline. So they are collocations that you need to remember. Two more to go. Number 9, the correct answer is A. I'm hopeless. I tried every imaginable solution, but nothing worked out. So imaginable means possible to think of, while imaginary is something that only exists in your mind. For example, she has an imaginary friend. And imaginative is someone who is good at thinking of new and original ideas. For example, he's an imaginative writer. And last but not least, the correct answer is B. The Spanish government has passed a new law making COVID tests compulsory for tourists. So the collocation is to pass a law, which means to accept a law by voting. Was it correct? If so, don't forget to add 1 point. So guys, how do you go? Did anyone get everything correct? 10 out of 10? If so, congrats, nice going, because this quiz was rather tricky, I must say. And guys, if you want to do a quiz every day, check out my Instagram account, EnglishBits_. There is a daily quiz. On Mondays, it's on grammar. Tuesdays, a phrase verb. Wednesdays, a collocation. Thursdays, a preposition. On Fridays, we've got slang. And Saturdays, an idiom. And on Sundays, there is a summary of everything we have learned during the week. And of course, guys, if you enjoyed this quiz, please don't forget to give it a huge thumbs up so that more people can find it and can do it. And also, please make sure you're subscribed to my channel and catch me on Instagram. With that being said, thanks for watching and see you next week. Ciao for now!